Good morning, Washington, D.C. We are McKinley Technology High School, located in Ward 5.
My name is Miera. I'm the communicator.
My name is Taj. I'm the inspiration.
My name is Kayla. I'm the promoter.
My name is Christian. I am the whiz kid.
I'm Mikias, the heart and passion.
I'm Devin, the mastermind.
I'm Gabrielle, the OG.
I'm Rolanda, the organizer. I challenge you, the students of Washington, D.C., to leverage technology and design a platform to engage with youth from around the world.
This platform should be scalable and convince high school students and society at large that engaging with people from different cultures should be a norm. Chris Plute.
As a STEM school, we wanted to see this challenge as a tool to utilize technology in order to further social ethnic understanding in person and virtually, making the world a better place.
I saw a headline on the news yesterday detailing a recent terrorist attack on a museum in Tunisia.
Yesterday on Twitter, I saw a tweet about a nuclear situation in Iran.
Why does the media focus on the bad and the negative?
Why does the media show the ancient Ottoman mosque in Iran or the rolling hills in Afghanistan?
Our mission was to create an annual event with supporting social media resources that highlights the cultural differences of people from different cultures in order to promote a better understanding.
On March 10th, we hosted our first Embassy Day at our school.
Embassy Day had three main goals: create a platform, dispel stereotypes, establish a link between schools and the embassies.
We hosted different stations and encouraged youth to sign up for EPALS, which connects students from different countries.
At the end of Embassy Day, students shared powerful reflections and powerful feedback about how Embassy Day changed their lives.
Take a look at some memorable moments.
We plan to host Embassy Day every year, and this year we signed up over 50 students for EPALS. We've also gotten approval from administration to join Global Nomads in the Pulse program and are planning a trip to Passport, D.C.
We can use many methods to bridge the division between cultures.
Embassy Day was part of our solution. Here's our video.
Breathing you in when I want you.
We challenge you, Washington, D.C., to host Embassy Day 2016 in your school. Generation W3, open minds, open worlds. We would like to thank
Aspen Institute and Chris Bull for providing us with many
resources.
Thank you.
Stay on stage. Give it up for McKinley. Ready. You guys did great. Did really good. All right. Do we have questions from the judges?
I'm not sure if it's on. Oh, perfect. So congratulations on your first launch of Embassy Day. You picked Japan, Indonesia, Egypt, Malaysia. Why those countries first?
Well, these countries, you know, are some of the countries that people actually don't go to, or perhaps the students might not know. So we actually asked the students to locate some countries when we did interviews. You guys can see that later. So they didn't know about these countries. So we wanted to reach that and then let them in, share the cultures so that they may know and dispel stereotypes.
Also in 2013, we found a statistic that only 3.2% of Americans who traveled outside of the U.S. went to Africa and the Middle East. Mm. Any more questions?
You all mentioned that you use social media when you were doing Embassy Day. Can you talk a little bit more specifically about how you all use social media to engage your peers?
The three main social medias that are occurring in the world are Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And judging towards the youth, which was a part of the challenge, we used social media and more technological advances, including the website, in order to connect and distribute information about not only Embassy Day, but our motive and towards connecting them to other cultures, as well as presenting them with a way to connect for future innovations for the world.
We also used ePals that connects students from across the globe to chat and share ideas. We signed up over 50 students that day.
And on March 6th, we plan to host a Skype session with volunteers from the Peace Corps in Uganda and Moldova, but it snowed, sadly.
Great presentation. I need some advice. I just came back from Pakistan. Amazing experience. During the 2 weeks since I was there, there's been 3 suicide bombings. What advice would you give me?
The minority of extremists do not represent the majority of Muslims. Chris Plute taught us that.
And, some more advice that I would give you is to, don't stay closed-minded. Open up your mind to, other places in the world. So try to benefit Pakistan, try to benefit Israel. Just try to help other places.
And the main catalyst towards that is Generation W3. And starting off with not only opening your mind, but creating a positive innovation not only helps you out, but helps out your background, and especially the background of Pakistan, which will help prevent problems like this.
Any other questions?
Thank you.
Any other?